You know, when I think of Whitney Houston, I think of her as a distant family member. I sung The Greatest Love of All at my sixth grade graduation ceremony. Again, the song re-entered my life at first at my sixth grade graduation, and then again with my first radio professional studio session. And I sung that song in the studio for the first time. And when Whitney re-recorded that song and made it a remake, and that song came back into my life, I felt freshly connected. So I'm reaching out and sending out my condolences, trying to process my feelings about her passing. So I'm trying to especially connect through the song The Greatest Love of All, which is a song that's dear to me in my life. So I just wanted to do something to acknowledge and to dedicate something to the memory and the love that Whitney brought into my life through her music and through the songs that she sung. And now, you know, when I heard she passed away, it was at a, I was at an immediate loss of words, being that she was so young, so unsure of how to feel regarding her death. It's like I cut off my emotions, or, you know, I just kind of shut down for a moment, for not knowing how to process the information that I was just given. So, in my personal angst with regard to the loss of such a tremendously talented human being, I wanted to do something here, and we wanted to do something here at Now and Forever Broadcasting, and we felt compelled to do something, to dedicate our lives, our talents to the memory of Whitney Houston. This segment here is a tribute and recognition segment dedicated to the one and only Miss Whitney Houston. May God rest your soul and be with your family and your friends. From Douglas and O'Neill Fan, right here on Now and Forever Broadcasting. Thank you. I'm
So I No matter. No matter what I say. Because love, they take it. I love you. Till love is a great love.